Today's game is coming to you live from Hexxon, Texas, at the raucous AK-47 Stadium, home of the $10 Bible, beer, and bullet combo meal. The crowd is armed, overzealous, and drunk, so basically a normal Sunday here in Hexxon. Today's matchup is going to be a good one. The teams take the field. The New Goreleans Zombies battle the Hexxon Oilers. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. Hi, everyone. Grim Blitzrow with you on MFL Game Day. Hey, Bricks, do you smell something burning?
Thanks for reminding me. I left my rubber foot in the toaster oven to warm it up. Last time I left it there too long, it came out like Saganaki. Opa! It's freezing in here.
Hey, why don't you take a shampoo and ouzo, stick your head in the toaster oven. That'll warm you up.
And it's first and 10. And that's the way to get the sticks moving. He picks up 5 on that play. Second down and 5. And that'll bring up 3rd down and 7. And they'll line up for the punt here. He boomed that one. Let's see if they can get the return man catches the ball. He is fighting for every yard. Oh, mama. He just knocked him into the next time zone.
Once he finds his head, he'll be okay.
And it's 1st and 10. Defense gives up 5 yards there. Second down and 5. And the defense gets the quarterback for a sack. Down and the punter is warming up. And out comes the most underrated position in football, the mighty punter. Nice punt. Should move him back nicely. And he snags the punt and looks for open field. The brain scrambler. And it's 1st and 10. Ooh, that hit's gonna shave a few days off his life. And it's 1st and 10. Roid rage. Because if you can't answer your question with violence, you've got to catch that. Second down and 10. Talk about butterfingers. He should have had that one. Third down and 10. Well, sometimes the best thing to do is just punt and let your defense get the ball back.
Apparently, the punter for the day is being played by my kid's sister, and she doesn't have legs.
And he just lets that one go. He says, no, thank you, and the defense downs it. First and 10. Oh, this guy just loves punishing the defenders. That's a first down. And it's first and 10. That, my friends, was an all-pro MFL hit. Second down and 7. Listen, he just used his beat.
Ooh, hope he's got a good chiropractor.
And that'll bring up third down and 7. Not much there, maybe a yard. Well, here comes the punting unit. You know, punters really do know how to party, Bricks.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah, I have pictures that, well, maybe actually shouldn't discuss this on here. He's got the ball now and is going to try and score.
You ever get hit in the head with a boat all grim?
Nope.
Well, I have on several occasions.
Not surprising.
Multiple times on each occasion.
Not surprising.
And trust me, that hit was worse.
Man, oh man, he hit that line the way your wife hits the all-you-can-eat buffet at Crabapple Tree, Bricks.
You're telling me. She ate 47 Salisbury steaks one time. Thought she had food poisoning. Turns out her low intestines just exploded.
Oh, that's a relief, because there's nothing worse than food poisoning.
Oh, you're telling me.
That ball just sliced through the defense like butter.
I wish defenses were made out of butter. That'd be fantastic.
Able to grab that one somehow and hold on for the first down.
This guy has a nice set of hands, Grim. It's the third set of hands he's had sewn on today. Looks like it's a good fit.
And it's first and 10. Okay, nice and easy like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and, or bloodthirsty, whichever. It's anyone's game still at this point.
I know, which makes it so hard to place a bet.
And it's first and 10. Defense holds him to a 4-yard pickup there. Second down and 6.
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
Third and 4. He broke free and has open field in front of him. 10, and they're catching up.
Joke, job, do something.
Man, he's dancing like a zonked out jam band enthusiast.
Oh, that's how he spends an entire off season.
Don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
Straight through the uprights. They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
First and 10. The quarterback passes the ball and it rebounds back.
He can't get rid of it. It's like me and these crabs, Grim.
Yes, the defense calls a sticky ball dirty trick and the QB is in a heap of trouble now. Second down and more than the QB would like. Third down and forever. And that is a big gain. You know the defense wants some payback after that. Don't do anything stupid here. Just punt the damn ball and play defense. And he got it off. That's a decent punt. And it's first and 10. And the quarterback finds his man for the first down. It's first and 10. Oh, he almost broke that one wide open.
Hey, speaking of breaking one wide open, who's sitting on the oil rig about to blow? Hey, smells like an oven baked port-a-john in here. We're a freaking fracking accident waiting to happen. Don't nobody light a match.
The defense calls a sticky ball dirty trick. The quarterback can't dump it.
And now they're gonna dump his ass.
And that'll bring up third down and 7. And that was a perfect pass, and he scores handily. Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
They need a good return here to set up the offense. He sets up for the return. Let's see if he can break one wide open. And it's first and 10. It's 2 yard run before he stopped. And that'll be second and 8 to go. nicely done for a first down. And it's first and 10. That's a 4-yard gain. Second down and 6. And he held on to that one for a first down. And it's first and 10. Caught for the first down. Smart move there, stopping the clock with their first timeout.
And for all you know, maybe he's just stalling or wiring the ref some cash.
And it's first and 10. Oh, and did he just put on a display there? Touchdown! Some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth 7.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sit.
It's good. The teams are lined up for the kickoff. Looks like he'll be able to run this one back if he's not terrified for his life.
He is, but he's got no choice.
First and 10. I hope you covered your ears, Bricks, because that was a sonic blast, and then catch will give them a first down.
I don't know if they're his, but he sure has a good set of hands.
And they take their first time out.
How predictable. Surprise us next time. Call the timeout during halftime.
And it's first and 10. One in for the first down. The quarterback is controlling the clock right now like the clock is into it.
He just clock blocked the clock.
And the offense goes into the hurry up formation to try to conserve time. And he was stuck to him like glue. Quarterback goes into a hurry-up offense. He's looking for a quick score.
Aren't we all, Grim? Aren't we all?
And that's a sack. The quarterback has to get rid of the ball there. Third down, and that's the last timeout. They can't stop the clock anymore.
Can any of us really stop the clock, Grim? I mean, when it comes right down to it, are we not all united by the constant reminder of our own mortality? Of death's constant, relentless advance? If only it was as easy as telling that timeout to stop our own clock. You know?
And he reels that one in for a first down to keep the drive alive.
Nah, that's not fair. Someone should call a penalty on this ref.
Yeah, the death penalty. Hang him by the nuts.
Third down in the offense. Offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. Third down and the QB is saying his prayers. Can't chance for a big game.
But still not enough for a first. Even I'm frustrated, and I'm a team agnostic. I want Sean Kick to make a kick like this with his extra leg.
It's a tie game at the end of quarter two. The teams are deadlocked in a fierce struggle today. We'll be right back with today's halftime show brought to you by Monsatan Industries. Eat their delicious Frankenfood.
Hey, throw in the half. Can you pick me up a Soylent beer?
Third quarter, we are all tied up and set to kick off the second half.
Speaking of all tied up, Grim, how many of them elephant laxative pills did I take? I feel like I'm sitting on Mount Vesuvio right now. One false move, and I'm gonna blow!
Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were gonna tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed, it was a chip wearing a wig.
And it's first and ten. Nice run for 5 yards. Second down and five. He took a beef boost injection. Now wants it double. And the MFL keeps pounding out the death hits on WMFL 98.8. The greatest hits of all time.
Huh? Did you just say greatest hits? Where?
And they line up for the extra point. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five. He just got crushed. And it's first and ten. This guy's gonna get mugged in the locker room by his team after the game. Second down and ten. A nice run there for 8 yards. Third and two.
Hit that line the way a Republican congressman hits the airport men's room. Good and hard. First down.
And it's first and ten. That's a 6-yard gain. And that'll be second down and four. Just follow the bloody footprints to the new line. That's a first down. And it's first and ten. The way to move the chains. That's good for a first down. This game is all about momentum and killing. First and four. Oh, what a punishing hit that was. And that's how you make a guy remember your name and your shoe size. Because he just walked all over him. And that'll be second down and four.
One time, when I was playing, a guy hit me so hard, I went into a dark tunnel. Thought I saw my grandparents waving at me in the light. Turns out it was just the visitor's tunnel that he knocked me into, and it was the paramedics waving fingers in my face.
And he catches it for a touchdown! What a beautiful play!
Yeah, it's almost poetic, man. Like a haiku!
Okay, nice and easy like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Glenn.
Straight through the uprights. When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
And it's first and 10. If there were any functioning brain cells before that hit, they're gone now. He's gonna have the IQ of a rutabaga after that hit. And that'll be second down and four. That's a killer. It was right there, and then he dropped it.
Oh, scumbag is killing me in the fantasy league.
Third and four. Works at the Mutant Stud Farm weekends and summers. Full man, about a 6-yard gain.
Hey, do me a favor. If my parole officer calls, I was with you last night, Bricks.
No problem. I spent the night in lockup for solicitation.
It's not too often a quarterback gets rejected.
That's why that's the position I originally tried out for. I want to know what it's like for other people to accept you.
Now that went from a joke to making me feel feelings. Stop it. This isn't a place to... And he was running like he had a load in his pants. Picks up maybe two.
We always ran with a load in our pants, Grim. It's a pretty good defensive tool. Except the zombies. They are freaks.
Rainbow. They just let that one drop and played safe, and the defense says we'll take it. And it's first and 10. Great run for a 9-yard gain. And that'll bring up second and 1. We're tied up at the end of the third quarter. You can smell the excitement on the fans. I mean, literally, it is ripe in here. Man.
Junior, was that you?
Hey, blow me.
The defense didn't give an inch. No gain on that play. And that'll bring up third and 1. With the brutal hit. And it's first and 10. Oh, and that one's gonna hurt. He may not be able to comprehend math after that hit. Second and 8 to go. And picks up maybe a deuce at most.
Speaking of deuces, I got a... hey, you got a dollar for the bathroom attendant? He threatened me if I didn't tip him next time.
Well, it looks like he wanted to run before he caught it. You gotta keep your eye on the ball.
Come on, you dirtbag. You gotta make that catch.
And the punter takes a break from knitting on the sidelines to come in and punt.
His knitting is superb, Grim. The cross-stitching, unbelievable.
And he's got a chance for a good return here. Pow! And how about a little dirt sandwich? And it's first and 10.
Murphy Brown!
What?
I mean, first down!
What the hell was that?
I honestly don't know, Grim.
And it's first and 10. Defense better watch out. The quarterback just threw a murder ball.
I'd love the murder ball.
Catch the ball, get the first down, and don't die. See, it's really...
Oh, that is such bullshit. I got money on this game. These guys need to talk to the ref about those calls. If I talk, I mean stomp them into the ground.
And this is a first and long. And they've had enough. The offense jumps on sides and attacks the ref. First down and forever. And the back gets in there and swats the ball away.
He can't catch, but he sure can swat.
Second down in a mile. Yard gain there. That's a solid pickup.
I wish people would do solid pickups more often. I step in dog turds on my front porch every day.
Third down and forever.
He could go all the way.
Well, back to the bench. He dropped it, you putz.
Defense called a sticky ball dirty trick, and the quarterback is in a shitload of trouble.
He's trying to throw the ball, Grim, but it keeps coming back to him.
That play was like the offense was playing rock, paper, scissors, and the defense was playing rocket launcher. And now the defense has the ball because they came to play. First and 10. And that's the way to get the sticks moving. He picks up 5 yards on that play. Second down and 5. The quarterback passes the ball and it rebounds back.
He can't get rid of it. It's like me and these crabs, Grim.
Yep, the defense calls a sticky ball dirty trick, and the QB is in a heap of trouble now. Third down and 8. Wow, the quarterback just threw a sonic blast to his receiver. Oh, nice hit. Oh, first and 10. He caught it, and nothing was going to stop him from getting into the end zone.
Except maybe self-doubt, but he seems to have worked through it.
Some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth 7.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sinners then.
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. First and 10. Two minutes left in the game, and we'll be right back after I top off my drink.
Grab me a scotch while you're up.
Second down in a very lot. That's a vicious hit, and the crowd loves it.
He just turned that guy into 300 pounds of ground.
And they stop the clock with their first timeout to try and stay in this game.
Oh, nice coaching move there. Hall of Fame caliber.
Well, I mean, it's a pretty standard coaching move at this point of the game.
I won't listen to this blasphemy.
They've got one more timeout left, but they've stopped the clock.
Why don't they just take the batteries out of the clock, Grim? That would make more sense.
In a hurry-up offense, there is no huddle, so neither team can put their players on the bench. The defender says, "I don't think so." It's first and 10.
That was a nice piece of running, Grim. That's a first down.
And defense burns its last timeout. You can't take them into the locker room, so you might as well use them now.
Why would you want to take a timeout into the locker room, Grim? That doesn't sound right.
It's about a 3-yard pickup. Second down and 7. And into the end zone for a touchdown. Once he got his hands on that pass, he was off to the races. Here comes the extra point attempt. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. Knocked him into the next time zone.
Once he finds his head, he'll be okay.
The offense goes into their 2-minute drill.
What the hell is that?
It's the same thing as a hurry-up offense, you moron.
I am so confused.
That's the way to keep the chains moving. That was beautiful.
And it's first and 10. He just heard footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a peck ahead. Catch the ball, asshole.
offense goes into their two-minute drill.
Which coincidentally happens to be Brent's match stutzing time.
That's why the girls call me Speedy Gonzalez.
Boom, and he's dead.
Oh, bingo, bingo, bingo. I got bingo, Grim. Don't you just love the sound of bones snapping and cracking? I mean, when they're not yawn.
The Oilers got spoiled today and come up with a loss. And let's go down to the field and hear the MVP. He's a real role model for the kids, Bricks. That is, if you want your kids to be a roid-raging narcissist with uncontrollable verbal diarrhea.
Well, that personality disorder has a name. It's called autotrophism.
Hey, man, I was hanging on the pillow now.
Once again, the folks at Evil SN thank our viewing audience and the Mutant Football League for allowing us to telecast this sports presentation. This is Grim Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. signing off.
Today's game was brought to you by the Hexxon Oil Corporation. We drill it, spill it, and kill it, so...